interesting because the times
woke up this morning thinking about
those summer days.
Best friend got caught up when I stayed in Douglasville.
What's good, y'all? Welcome back to another video. So today, making a J. Cole's Kevin Hart. I love J. Cole, man. Not like that, but like I like his music. Good artist. I'm freaking... Okay, it feels bad. I just had like this weird... Today is a great day. I just want to make a video. Tell y'all that I love making YouTube videos. Once I make it, I'm going to have a whole, like, hour story to tell people. Because I got so much to say. Like, on a daily, I be dealing with the nightmares I be having. Stuff I want to talk about. But that's in the future. Let's get into the video. Y'all be sure to like, subscribe, shout out to People That Genius.
It was back in October, I think 2016. I was meeting up with a friend named Mark Pelly. He's an incredible guitarist. We got in the studio and he gets on the guitar and he just starts playing this guitar loop. And I was just like, yo, this is incredible. Like, it's super jazzy. It was just dope, a dope vibe, you know what I mean? I'm really into like stuff that brings out like emotion in the music. So when I heard those chords, I was just like, yo, you gotta just fuck with it and just do something with it. And we just built on it and it became what it was.
Slip me a Zanny at once. Somebody. I got the earth and the blunt. Smoke. I get the skirt when I want. I get the skirt when I want. Due to the money aroma.
Somebody.
My girl, she got a diploma. Smoke. She got white written all over. She got white written all over.
I try not to think about other artists when I'm creating because we often think about what an artist wants back in the day, you know, or before. And we always have to think ahead as producers, what could an artist be on that they've never been on? Yeah. When I sent Cole that track, he was in the process of building his secret album, The KOD Project. I didn't know about it. I don't think anybody really knew about it. I don't even think he even knew about it, you know, at the time, because he's just creating organically. And, you know, I threw that track to him and it just fit the mold of the project so well. Cole is an incredible lyricist and songwriter, so I just knew he was going to deliver something just crazy on the track, you know, and he did. When I first started Kevin's Hart, I linked up with this guy, Mark Pelly. He's a great friend of mine, incredible guitarist, and, you know, he was just playing some guitars, but this is how it all started. The moment I heard that, I just knew, you know, that was something special. And then he adds a couple of layers after we recorded this. It was a crazy vibe, but I wanted to make something interesting out of it, you know, so I started stacking effects. I added this effect called Retrocolor, which I use a lot. I mean, it gives you that, you know, vintage feel. I threw this over top with a little bit of like digital distortion that gives it that like kind of video game feel.
The 8-bit sound, I get it.
It doesn't really sound like a guitar. It kind of sounds like a synthetic feel, but I just always try to elevate the track to the next level and make the sound interesting. The next thing I'm thinking is to add bass. I opened up this VST, it's called the Tau Uno. It's pretty much like a mimic of the Juno. So I pulled out this bass, did a little tricks to it, messed with the effects, and I came up with this. The bass is pretty much, you know, mimicking what's going on with the chords. I just really copied what Mark played. So from there, I just wanted to add a little bit more bottom presence, so I started adding an 808. The 808 was just from a BWB pack. I always have like a little bend in my bass. It's like a little signature thing I would always do, but I don't know, I just felt like it added a little character in the bass. Usually I add the kick next because, you know, the bass kind of has to marry with the kick really well. It has to just knock together really, you know, perfectly. It's a pretty simple pattern. So after that, you know, I started adding hi-hats. And then I added a second hi-hat. There's another hi-hat that I added as well. The next sound I'm gonna be looking for is a snare. So pull up the snare right here.
My eye right here. My apologies, everyone. I know people about
I just wanted
the,
to EQ
you know.
Some of the sounds a bit. So, you know, I took away some of the highs. And then I added a drum shaper. Pretty much I layered that snare with a clap, and you know, together this is what it sounds like. The next thing in line that I thought of was to add some percussion sounds. That's just like a minor clap that sits under the track, so when you play with the other snares. I also added an open hat, you know, just to, you know, hit every time before the snare comes in. And then I added this little percussion, almost like a hollow bongo sound. This is pretty much all the drum tracks together playing at once. So after I did all the drums, I had the guitar, I had the bass. I just wanted to add a couple more things to bring out the, you know, a hook section almost. So, you know, I pulled another sound from the Tau Uno. If you look here, it's echoing and the pitch is up all the way. There's almost this falling effect that's happening in the lead, and I did it with this plugin here, Effectrix, if you listen carefully.
Yeah.
The next effect that I added is called Crystallizer. It's pretty much adding like a sense of reverb or doubling.
I'm gonna get very good at from the sound. Like one day I'm gonna take like 5 years.
Another sound that I added to the track was just like a random, almost paddish effect.
The genuine beats with any
sound that I found from Omnisphere. It's called Communion.
It's not that, but Bill Mahoney's sound.
Whale singing effect. That actually has an effect over top, so I added retro color to that. So if I add it with the drums, you'll hear it like this. It's a really simple beat. We got the guitar, we got the bass, we got an 808 just to add some bottom, and the lead. It's really simple.
She my number one, I don't need nothing on the side. Said that I was done for good and don't want.
Remember when that song came out? I think I emotionally checked out a one relationship. Yeah. That's the thing with me. I feel like I'm cheating if I emotionally step out. Physically step out. Or like... Yeah. But, you know, over time, you know, as a man, you learn how to be loyal. You learn how to appreciate one woman because you don't want to be lonely.
No more lies. No,
what I like about the beat a lot is that it has trap elements, but it's very soulful. It's very musical. And I think that Cole's album pretty much embodies a lot of that. All a nigga knows how to fuck a good thing up. Run from the pain, sip lane, smoke tree up. When I'm in your- I know Cole definitely has a lot of respect for me as a producer. I'm big on like sound choices and things just sounding right in the track. I'm like a doctor when it comes to this. Like I'll go through 100 kicks, 200 kicks until I find the right one. I'll go through 100 snares until I find the right one. So I think he really appreciates that aspect.
The disrespect.
I'm all about the production and he understands that. And he's just a crazy lyricist. So it's just like, you know, it's a perfect situation. When I look in the mirror.
Yeah, Jesus. That being said, loves KOD from J. Cole. My favorite song was like Windowpane. Yeah. I woke up with a new mindset today. I'm like, I work a lot of jobs, but not a lot of jobs I'm not happy with. I'm gonna be real with y'all. Chase y'all dreams. You have to work a shitty job, chase your dreams. If you don't even wanna work and you wanna just fucking chase your dreams. If you have to be homeless, chase your dreams. If you have to, shit, live in the worst environment, chase your dreams. Don't be settled, don't just relax. Because this, in 5 years, is going to be something. that job in 5 years, I can have all the money in the world. That money don't mean so nothing to me no more. I've seen money before. You know, when you see money, you know, like, okay, how do you want to make a living? Or you want to make a living doing what you love? Or you want to make a living doing this that you're good at? And I'm just one of those people that believe in, I invested too much. I did literally so much for myself when it comes to this music and YouTube and everything, where it's like, I don't know nothing else I want to do like that. I want to film. I got stuff I've been doing for a bit now. But still, it's like, I need to be able to, like, I need to be able to keep doing this. Keep growing. I can't stay stagnant. I tell everyone, don't stay stagnant. When it comes to your dreams, just keep doing it. It doesn't matter if you don't get no attention now. Attention's gonna come over time. That being said, be sure to like, subscribe, comment below your favorite song from KOD. Shout out to T-Minus. Stay tuned to the next video. Peace. Ariel the poet.